Hi nerds, hi yogis, welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel and a Nerdy Yogi studio. I'm Carlene Rose and today we are doing a bombshell blast inspired by Wonder Woman. Very excited about this fierce warrior action. We're going to get on with our yoga shred inspired workout, do a yoga hit type flow. To start, come into a seated goddess pose or robotic konasana. We're going to just start by waving back and forth, letting the body know that we're going to start moving, get it to wake up a little before we get into the intensity of the practice. And come to center and we'll start activating our breath. So inhale here, deep to the low belly. Expand everything wide and exhale, squeeze everything in and up, all the way up through the nose. Inhale here. Even place your hands at your low belly to feel that expansion and exhale, squeeze everything in and out. Inhale and exhale. Continuing to use that breath this time as we wave ourselves into more of a forward fold. Awesome. From here, you can walk yourself to one side. Walk yourself over to the other. And just continue that waving motion. Roddy likes the waving motion. It's a very calming way to start warming up the body and getting it prepared for a workout. Walk yourself back up and coming to a wide leg pose. Find a comfortable position here for your legs. You don't have to worry about laying flat. We're going to continue that waving motion. And just like we did in the first pose, you'll walk to one side. Wave the spine long. Hold this pose for just a few breaths and continuing that wave motion, making sure you have a long spine and then fold. Maybe the exhale takes you a little deeper. Awesome. And then back through center. Come to the left side, inhale here, long spine before making a fold. And again, we're not worried about touching our leg or anything like that. We're just letting gravity do its work. Finding the first moments of stretch. And being okay with the fact that you might be different on both sides. Maybe one leg's tighter than the other. You know, so it happens a lot with our dominant legs, so. Back to center, waving yourself down again to that first edge of stretch. Inhale here, long spine. Exhale, you can let that fold naturally. And walk yourself back up. From here, we are going to make our way to a standing pose. So we'll come into a temple position. So again, with this yoga hit or yoga shred inspired type workout, we are using yoga anatomy and alignment to do these more high intensity workouts. This way, we are being gentle on our joints and, you know, getting a lot more bang for our buck. So we'll come into our temple pose here. And in this pose, you want to make sure that your knees and toes are facing the same direction. Otherwise, we're going to torque our knees and we will be coming in and out of that pose. So that'll be part of the movement. So we'll inhale here, exhale through Fierce Warrior. So Fierce Warrior, you're going to press out through your palms, pressing out through your side, and then stretch out the fingertips. Inhale up, exhale through that Fierce Warrior. Now I really want you to push with Fierce Warrior. It's not a flimsy move. Otherwise, you're not going to feel it in your arms. So really engaging the palms and the arm strength as you do that. We'll do that for the first four rounds. And then we'll tap into our sword fighting skills that Wonder Woman has. And we'll hands, heart, center, namaste. And exhale, we'll have some swords. Well, we'll exhale swords here. So inhale, hands, center, namaste, and center. And exhale, your swords. So it should be fun. All right, so got my Tabata timer counting down for us, so we don't have to worry about counting time or reps. We just have to worry about alignment and going at a good pace that's challenging, but not going to completely wear you out of breath. So, starting by Fierce Warrior, so inhale here, exhale, inhale up, exhale. Now I'm going a little slower pace to start to make sure that I'm giving you the cues and everything. But remember, we're also going to be doing 8 rounds of this, so you really do want to challenge yourself, but you also want to make sure you're doing it in a healthy way. To rest, we can walk back and forth, and we hear the bell, we come back into our prep pose, inhale here, exhale, Fierce Warrior. Notice I am bending my arms on the way up. Just want to have good shoulder alignment as we're doing this as well. Awesome. Make your way walking back and forth. This will help give you that moment of rest, calm your heart just a little between rounds. Inhale here, exhale. If you fall, well, hey, that's totally cool. Happens in yoga all the time, right? The mark of a true yogi or warrior is not the falling, it's the getting back up. All right, this will be the last round of this one. Inhale here, exhale. Notice we're getting a bit of a cardio, a bit of a strength workout while we're doing this. Challenging our body for just a short amount of time, but getting a lot of benefits. Awesome. Whew. Walk it out and shake it out too. That feels good. And this time we'll reverse it a little. So start in your temple, hands at heart center, arms stay in. Bust out your swords. Now, same thing with this, like your Fierce Warrior Mudra. You really want to put some strength in the arms. It's not flimsy arm movement. We're really activating that. You can work out your arms without any weights. And that's kind of what we're doing here with that movement. So really think about the resistance. Imagine that the air is really thick and you're having to slice through it with your God Killer sword. And feel free to breathe through your mouth if you need to. That does sometimes give you more oxygen. And oxygen is, of course, key when we're doing intense movements like this. And back into temple here. Minding the good alignment, making sure you're starting there and then increasing your pace as long as you can keep the alignment. All right, step back and forth. If you need a little bit more rest, you can hit pause and have some water, of course, at any time. Almost done here, yogis. Remembering to breathe. Strong swords. And we're done. Whew, awesome. Step back and forth. Catch your breath. And then from here, we'll come back into a temple, but we'll make it more of a flowing temple. Again, calming our heart rate and stretching out the muscles that we just used. And if your heart rate's calm enough, you can come into a side angle pose. So right leg is bent, left arm is reaching long overhead, stretching the left leg long as well. And switch sides. Then from here, making your way a little lower, doing some ninja lunges. Stretching the inner thighs, those definitely got worked. And then face your toes forward. Inhale here, prepare with the long spine, coming into a forward fold, a wide leg forward fold. Again, finding that first edge of stretch. You can wave back and forth here. Walk yourself to one side. And to the other. To the center. If you like here, you can even interlace your fingers behind your back and fold a little deeper. Awesome. And one last moment is if you come into a forward fold with your fingertips pointing you, you can stretch the forearms. Bend the elbows even, get a little deeper stretch, lean back a little bit in your heels. And awesome, from there, make your way down to your final resting pose. You definitely have earned it. So legs out long, just relax everything into the earth. Take these warrior ways with you into the rest of your day. Hopefully you did enjoy this practice. I look forward to practicing with you again next week. If you're not already, make sure that you've subscribed to the YouTube channel. That way you get notifications when the new videos come out. And of course, share this with anyone that you think might enjoy it. It's always good to have a community of friends going along this yoga journey with you. And as always, you can get on the League of Nerdy Yogis email list for some exclusive content. Namaste.